A Walk with Don Bosco. Don Bosco was a man who lived in the 19th century, but is today acclaimed as the saint for all ages. In his lifetime, he waded through utter poverty, struggled to cling on to his dream and fulfill it, not just for himself, but for others, performed miracles, not only of the supernatural kind, but also very down-to-earth ones, wrote innumerable texts in spite of and through his hectic running around, prayed while he worked, and worked while he prayed, ever mindful of God's presence and guidance in his life. Of the several qualities that can be enumerated about this saint of the young, we highlight one of them, his ability to touch people's lives. Several people came into the life of Don Bosco. He walked with them all. In his lifetime, he interacted with kings, rulers, diplomats, ecclesial authorities, businessmen, common folk, and most closely with the young, especially those abandoned to fate and misery. Of all these people, some Don Bosco followed. He gladly walked behind them. Luis Comolo, Joseph Cafasso. A few he confronted face to face. Archbishop Gastaldi. Others he showed the way, letting them take a different path than his own. Mary Mazzarello. Very many he led with great tenderness and affection, walking before them as a father and friend. With very many, he walked hand in hand, shoulder to shoulder, those whom he called the long hands of God. The laity who supported as collaborators and helpers at the oratory, especially in its infancy. Those who walked with him, whether for long or short duration of their lives, were so touched by his charisma that they were never the same. Their life took on a different turn after their encounter with the saint of the young. Most of his boys went on to become what Don Bosco wanted them to be, good Christians and honest citizens. Some of his pupils became exemplary teenage saints in the Catholic Church. Dominic Savio, Mickey Magone, Laura Vicuña. A few turned out to be great missionaries in far-off places, places where Don Bosco dreamt of going himself but couldn't. Cardinal John Caliero, Father Vincent Chimati. Very many of the young people, inspired and trained by Don Bosco, joined the diocese and other religious congregations. It is said that Don Bosco contributed nearly 300 vocations from his oratory to the dioceses of Italy during his own lifetime. Some even founded new religious societies. Father Luigi Orione, Father Luigi Guanella. Quite a few of his boys chose to become Salesians and lead other young people just like Don Bosco did. Those who chose to walk with Don Bosco while living their own lives as lay people soon became the extended Salesian family, the Salesian cooperators, volunteers of Don Bosco, past pupils, benefactors, All these groups continue to work with Don Bosco, keeping alive his dreams and aspirations, setting off sparks of new life and enthusiasm among the people of the world, especially the young. Since 200 years of his birth, the Salesian family is spread in over 132 countries across the globe. The Salesians, priests and brothers alone, number 15,762 in the church. There are 30 groups, lay and religious, associated with the Salesian family. However, the real achievement that Don Bosco and those who follow him can boast of is the ability to touch and transform the lives of young people. The capacity to work with everyone of tender age or a heart for the young. On any given path, whether we walk alone or with others, today or tomorrow, as religious or professionals, what matters most is that those with us have been enriched by our presence more than ourselves, and that we have made the path a better place for those walking after us. Don Bosco truly wanted each one to become holy, each according to his or her state of life. He constantly reminded his sons, "The greatest gift that we can offer to the young is our holiness." He himself showed us the way by choosing to walk on the path offered to him by God, walk with Mother Mary as her constant companion, walk for the young people whose lives he touched and transformed.